called spoon scoops were used to hollow out the inside. By hand was a really tough job, 2 to 3 hours for one pair. By machines nowadays, 5 minutes.
Wow. 5 minutes, 5 minutes.
So the machine will make the outside shape, works the same way as duplicating a key. We're gonna make a copy of the model. German machine for the outside, a French machine for the inside. They're both about 80 years old.
Pass up, Lee. Yeah.
A podle toho to udělá obrázek. To je ono.
What do we need to make cheese?
Milk.
Obviously milk. And that's what we need to start off with. And that's what we do. In the morning around 4 a.m. we pour the milk inside this container. And as you can see, there's these three blades that keep on stirring the milk. That's very important for later. But the milk will get heated up to 29 degrees Celsius. And that is because of this liquid. And it's called rennet. And what is rennet? It's actually a bacteria taken out of the stomach of a cow. Yeah, and when you put this inside the milk will start to get really thick like a pudding. And because of the stirring, it will get divided into two parts. You get 90% of whey and then 10% of curds. And the whey you might know from whey powder or protein powder.
Yeah,
it's full of protein. So it's very nutritious, but that we don't need to make the cheese. We only need the 10% of curds.
Right.
And that's what we take. So you need about 10 liters of milk to make 1 kilogram of cheese. And this is a cheese form for 1 kilogram of cheese. As you can see, there's this net and little holes underneath. And we put the cheese, the curds inside and press it for about 2 hours. And it's very important to make sure that the cheese is solid and that the water, the excess of water will be pushed out. So afterwards, after those 2 hours, we take the cheese out of the form and then we put it in a salt bath. And in the salt bath, there's about 20% of salt and 80% water. And the salt is very important for preservation because back in the days we didn't have refrigerators. So we needed to make sure that it will stay good for a long time. And afterwards, it's also very nice for the flavor, the salt flavor. We take the cheese out of the salt bed after 24 hours, and then we put a layer of wax and then a layer of paraffin over it. And in the paraffin there are little holes, so that after the cheese is finished, it can breathe on the shelves. So the older the cheese, the drier and the saltier the cheese is, because the water can actually escape the skin of the cheese. So if you keep it for 1 month, it's called a young cheese, a jungkaas. After 6 months, it's considered a beleefkaas or a middle-aged cheese. And after about 2 years, it's called a mature cheese. So for example, this one, this cheese just broke, but it's very hard. It's 3 years old, this one. And oh god. And then this one is very soft, it's about 2 months old. And inside the shop you can try all different kind of flavors. We have over 25 different flavors, including this one. It looks like a sausage, but it's actually vegetarian. It's a smoked cheese. So the, how this cheese is made is we put it in a sack and then melt the cheese and put it on over over paraffin and wax. It's this also plastic, you cannot eat it. So you cut it in half and then you make sure that the wax is off, like this, right? And then you can use the cheese grater, the cheese slicer to make little slices. So who does?
Queres provar, Beatriz? Vai lá.
Watch out, it's very sharp. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.